Once again, we're here for the rehearsals of the second semi-final. And here I'm at the expo. These are the doors. And now I go in to watch. My favorite of this year, Norway, is in this semi-final. I'm rooting for them. Let's see.
When she go low, when she go low, she go solo, she go solo. Oh she know, oh she know, she got me dirty dancing. When she go low, when she go low, she go solo, she go solo. Oh she know, oh she know, she got me dirty dancing.
Denmark just finished their rehearsal and it's time for Sweden and the light thing that you know they have on the stage has broken down. Funny trivia, last year at this rehearsal for the second semi-final, Sweden's light platform broke again. They had to postpone it to the end of the show. What's going on? Every year the same thing. Come on Sweden, pull yourself together. today's second semifinal was kind of a letdown for me because I thought it was going to be much stronger than the first. The show-wise, there was nothing, literally. There was no opening. For the interval, there was another band that is not related to Eurovision, although they were really good. They had disabled members, and they did a really good job. I mean, the songs are just stronger in the semifinal, but the overall flow, I don't know, it kind of didn't work. Netherlands is kind of low-key, as you know. Norway is my favorite, but they don't have the greatest stage presence, I can say. I mean, there are three people, but it really doesn't fill up the stage. There's not much to see. And Azerbaijan was pretty good. He's vocally great. I mean, it sounds really good. But I was hoping to see something very technical and interesting by the end. They talk about surprise. Apparently, that's just for the screens, for the TV. It's not, you can see it on the arena. But his show was nice. Russia doesn't speak to me, really. I love the song. I mean, I don't love the song, but I enjoy the song. But I thought they were going to carry on with that medieval thing. But it seemed more organic. This seems like very tech heavy. It doesn't give me any feeling, any human feeling. And after that, North Macedonia does a similar visual with the mirror effects. And they're after Russia, so I think that will be the one remembers, no? I don't know. I mean, always the second semi is always less spectacle. But because the songs are stronger, I was expecting to have more fun. It was meh. Romania was good. I remember Malta was good. I enjoyed Malta. It's not a winner. It's not a winner performance, but it's good. I like it because the song is nice. And she gives more energy than you think, because she seems a little cold, like Blanche, or you know, maybe, but she moves and she smiles and she delivers. Around the press center, I had falafel. I was so hungry. It was the best thing I've ever eaten. It was really good. I mean, if you're around the press center, have those falafels. Charlotte Perrelli is going to be on the Eurocafe stage tonight, so I'm gonna film her. You might not know this, but she is the owner of my former favorite song from Eurovision all time, Take Me to Your Heaven. I think it was dethroned lately by Monsters, by Sara also. I gotta accept this now. It just is the truth. By Genghis. Anyway.